Hello guys, today I have for you the Royal Kludge Rk61 keyboard, 60%. I got this from Banggood, which I will put in the description. A lot of people who buy keyboards and other tech stuff buy stuff from Banggood. But yeah, let's open this up. And let's see. Let's just see it, I guess. Okay, we open. Okay, and we have the keyboard right here in a nice plastic wrap. I'll show you guys right here. I ordered mine in black, so that it, I don't know, I just like black. Just went with it. It comes with this little Chinese. I'm not really sure, and I'm part Japanese, so I should know. I'm pretty sure this is Japanese. It's like a little card, I guess. This is just shows there's a wire.
Yeah, like right there. Okay. And this, I don't know what this is.
Oh, I know what this is. So it comes with a wire. I'm gonna test how long it is. Measure it later, but I hope it's long enough for my setup. So yeah, and it comes with a keycap puller. So if I buy a keycap set, which I am planning to do, I'll use this. Comes with a little manual in English, Dutch, and Japanese. I seriously don't know, but yeah, that's everything else in the box, the actual piece that we need. So I'm about to, if I can find the end of it. Here we go. About to pull it out. And there it is. The magic of it all.
Wow.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah.
So it looks like the arrow keys are down here near the function keys. So there's no arrow keys up here. All of the buttons are normal. Since it's 60%, the function keys are over here. I just have to use the function button. So let's do a sound test. Okay, so that was the sound test. I used the keycap puller real quick. I'll use the W key, I guess. Actually, we didn't even look at the switches, but I know they're blue switches, so I guess I'll use.
Because that is on top.
Oh, I used sideways. Why did I do it from the top? Okay, so I just put it in there and polish it from the top. The blue switch is actually kind of clicky, and it's actually satisfying. To click
it?
Yeah, go ahead. No, but you want to click it over here. It feels like,
like
click it here and then click with a keycap on. You feel like the difference?
Yeah,
there's more of a pull. There's more like,
yeah,
there's
that
more
one
force
is like so much lighter.
Yeah, with this is lighter. Yeah. So, I guess I just put the keycap back in. So yeah, I'm gonna show you the bottom. I don't know what that thing is, but right up. So we have the bottom. There's two rubber pads. No height adjustment, but if we look from the side, there's like a ledge, I guess. Yeah, you could see there's a height difference. So it goes down. Still good. I'll try to keep it as less dusty as I can. But, yeah, good keyboard. Now we're going to do the RGB. So I'm going to open up these wires and connect it. Be right back. Okay, guys, I'm about to plug it in so you guys can see the RGB when it turns on. I'm not fully connected in here. There we go. So it has the default RGB, I guess. Let's see the other filters. not filters, the other modes. Let's see right here. So this is number two. Just solid colors, I guess. Starting, or actually no, they're moving. Like a rainbow form, pretty cool. Number three, so it's sideways now. You're moving sideways. Number four, we can't tell, but I think if you guys can tell, they're moving like left, up, right. Right, left, right, up, left, sorry. Number four is reactive. So it makes the whole row, like shoot our lights. That's cool. Let me just show you guys. Let me see if I can up the strength, maybe. Okay, I found out where to control the brightness. So, I don't know if the brightness is higher. Let me see. I'm gonna turn off my light and see if it helps. Oh, it does help. Okay. So you can see it helps in the dark. Let me see if I can. Okay, that's a max light right there. Okay, number five. So it's like, okay, if you can see, it's the full. Man, this is really cool. It's the full, the whole keyboard from left and right. So I'm gonna go H. Oh shoot, I dropped some mice. yeah, so it goes like the whole side. Number six. This one, I think this one's actually better than the number five, so I'm gonna use this one. Because the other one sprouted it, and like, I guess this one's a thicker layer of light when it spreads. So, I think I like this one better. Number seven. This one is like a row. Let me see if I can get it all in one frame. Not in frame, but like on one. So, yeah. Number eight, it's like a zigzag, I can't tell what type of form this is, but yeah, pretty cool. Number nine, now this one's actually zigzag, so it's going zigzag toward top, bottom left to the top right. Number nine, there's 17 of them, so this might take a while. This one just solid colors, I guess, moving from each keycap, I guess. So it's not from each key. So I guess it's not like actual, whatchamacallit. It's not actual rows or columns, I guess, of each line. But yeah. I think we're up to number 10, if I'm not wrong. It's just blue. So I don't think it switches. I'm gonna split a while and see if it switches over time. No, I guess it just stays blue. This one's another reactive one. Like, it switches over time. Which key you press. Yeah, that's pretty cool. That was number 11. Number 12. Just random colors. And I don't think they switch. Oh, they do. If you press. Okay, so it fades if you press them and stuff. Pretty cool. And they switch colors after you press them. Number 13. Cause so like some turn off, some turn on, over and over again. Easy, simple. 14. So it's just an array of colors. Really cool. So pretty annoying in my opinion, but yeah. 15. Random colors again, and not real. Oh yeah, it changes color, so it doesn't fade like the number 11, I'm pretty sure. So it just changes color over time. Real solid colors, and you can see between each key, so it's kind of really cool. Number 16, second to last one. So it goes from blue to, so it's just like a breathing blue. Pretty cool. Not sure if it switches, but breathing blue it is. Oh, that's right. There's also, I can change the color. So I'm gonna just do it to this one so that you guys can see. I should have done it to the other one, but I didn't know. Now I noticed that I actually can switch the colors. So we have pink, white, or light, really light blue. I don't know. You choose. Red, yellow, green. Oh, that was like yellow green. Now it's green. Lighter blue, dark, more thicker blue. And then we're back to, I guess this is not pink, it's purple, but yep. Then we have number 17, final one. So this one actually changes, which is kind of cool. So I don't have to over all the time switch colors. But I'm planning on doing a hand cam now for all my videos. So if I were to do hand cams, I won't be doing the same mode all the time. I change over time so it doesn't get annoying for you guys. And we're back to number one. Yeah. This ain't number one. This one spreads from within. Hey, I know I was gonna count wrong. So I guess that's number 17? Yeah, this one's number one. Yeah, because it's good.
Well, that's it for today. I hope you guys liked the video. Please comment down if I should do like a review. I'm probably gonna do it in my next video. But this was just unboxing it and checking out the modes. I'll do a gameplay next video. So stay tuned for that. Comment down below what was your favorite mode and favorite color. And anything else. If you like this video, might as well like and subscribe if you like my content. See you guys in the next one. I know you're somewhere.